another round of applause for Sue. Woo! That was pretty awesome. So, all right. So we got more door prizes. First one we'll do, so we can require to name the whole thing. Canton, Ohio, established 1805. I'm assuming that's our latitude and longitude.
It is.
I hope it's our latitude and longitude.
It is.
It'd be funny if it was not.
That'd be awesome.
Be like, oh, here's the latitude and longitude for, you know, Antarctica. It's the latitude zero. Anyway. So, who is interested in Canton's latitude and longitude? We have one, two, three. Number between 1 and 4. James put his hand up first, so
I'm going to go with 2.
Okay.
4.
Ariana?
1.
Alright, Jesse wins. 4.
But you can buy one at Catnology if you want to.
Yes, you can buy one at Catnology. Our next door prize is a red stocking cap wrapped around a mug and other things. Who's interested in that? One, he started out with, he's Mr. Fabulous, and then just like a bunch of things, including, I think, comedy, and horror, and love, and
queer,
and Jesse, and all the, he didn't put that in. So instead I'll just say, I met him when I first started doing poetry up in the Cleveland area. A year before writing nights began, there was this place called the Enclave in Willoughby. It was an amazing little coffee shop that had like videos on the wall, and you could like borrow the video and just say, hey, I'm borrowing this video, and then bring it back later. And it was amazing. They had decent coffee, and they had an open mic. I don't remember the day anymore, but it was something I went to like consistently for like 5 or 6 months before writing nights ever started. So this is like a connection to like proto writing nights. So if you've ever heard of like what came first, the chicken or the egg, it's actually no proto chicken. So this is like, he's part of like the proto chicken of writing next. So please welcome Jesse James.
Intimate setting I've performed in quite some time.
Do you like to be intimate?
I do. I'm gonna steal this chair.
Yeah, feel free to sit.
Oh, yeah. I have mastered the art of playing guitar and standing up. Acoustic. We met some years ago. Wednesday nights at the Enclave.
Was it Wednesday?
Yeah, Wednesday. Well, it might have changed when it turned to Karma Coffee because I was there for both of them.
Yeah, because it was Wednesday, and then there was a drum circle like once a month or twice a month.
That's correct.
I went to that too. I don't know if you're
I did the drum circle once or twice. I my rhythm's not the best in the world. But it was always a fun time. I was there for 2 years, maybe. Do you remember Banjo Frank?
Sort of. I ran around with Zach and Colton and other Zach.
Yeah.
And Patrick.
But Yeah, I did that for quite some time, and this is the first time I've been back in like an acoustic, intimate setting since then. I've been doing band stuff recently. I'm in a band, Mr. Fabulous and the Bad Boys, and we've got some music out. I figured I'd play some of those songs, maybe play some old songs, and so we've got music on streaming services like Apple Music and Spotify, and the first couple songs here are the first songs off that album. This is called Adam's Adams. Some of these songs might sound a little bit better, but they definitely sound a lot better with the whole band arrangement, because I'm very mediocre and I surround myself with very talented people.
It's a good plan.
Yeah, that's the way to do it. That's why I love you guys going first, because like, you guys are amazing, absolutely phenomenal, like spectacular. And I love having excellent people play before me, because the bar is really high and I can soar right underneath it. This song's about having a really rough childhood and a bunch of stuff that didn't happen to me, but I'm sure it's happened to lots of people. This is called The Tragic Circumstances Involving Oliver Hayes. Doesn't matter anymore. awful, they poke, they point, they tease. Before I know it, I've got fleas. I'm drowning, I'm in over my head. Don't bother, I'm not leaving my bed. 18 is such a bummer year. Good thing the next one's so, so near. We haven't released it yet, it's on like YouTube and whatnot, but it's like a like Misery meets Carrie type vibe. I write all these really dark songs, and I'm like, wow man, you've got some issues. I'm like, no man, just creativity. So I say, this is called Frankenstein-like Obsessions. Gloomy when you were around me, you're speaking words of wisdom. I'm hanging on everyone, feeling like you can't see when you're around me. You are one of a kind. Be my Frankenstein. Finally get to meet you, I'm wondering what I could do to make a great impression, be your obsession. Drive up to your big house, sneak just like a small mouse, hide out in your pantry so you're around me.
Dang, this hurts.
A couple more for you. This song's a love song. If you ever get into writing music and whatnot, love songs are the easiest thing in the world to write. Like, just go straight for those. Although I told my boyfriend this is really tough to write and it took me forever. Got me out of doing chores for a couple weeks. I have like two verses down and the rest is all improv, so hopefully I don't mess it up too bad. This is called Dear You.